Mr. Tan Caktiong, you started to transition out of your CEO role at Jollibee about 2 years ago, just in time for all of this.
Yes.
Are you enjoying this job?
Yeah, it's very exciting to be bringing all the 21 head of states of the different economies. And then, as you mentioned, we'll have 700 to 800, probably 800 delegates to the CEO summit.
And ABAC, for example, this year has had four meetings, or will have four meetings, and you've been there for a while. Last year, you headed the SME committee of that.
One of the co-chairs.
Right.
Yes.
What's it been like to deal with these people, these other businessmen from around the world?
It's interesting because it's a nice networking, and then we learn from each other. And then, of course, each economies will have their own priorities, their own issues. So it's a matter of how do you get consensus, how do you convince each other, which one should be our recommendation to the APEC ministers.
Have you gotten any expansion plans, any expansion ideas or inspirations from meeting these businessmen from around the world?
Maybe we focus more on the ABAC work and not on the business side. So it's more learning in terms of urbanization, urban cities. They present water or sometimes e-commerce. So these are all the interesting ideas, and we hope that the Philippines can adapt.
Bill, you're an old hand in these kinds of events over the last 20 years at least. Mm-hmm. What's different about this one?
I think for this year for the Philippines, there's much more private sector participation with government officials. So it's not just the CEO summit, but for instance, the whole series of ministerial meetings. We have the finance ministerial meeting, which has a lot of banking executives attending. We had the trade ministerial meeting. We had a lot of CEOs, a few CEOs working with them. We just finished a meeting on with city mayors, one on services. We still have disaster management. We have a transportation ministerial and energy ministerial. In all those meetings, we've had more private sector participation, I think, than ever before. So the ministers, they meet by themselves, closed door meeting, but there's almost a lot of time given to have an exchange with CEOs. And I think that that's a big difference.
If one looks at the list of events just for APEC 2015, there's about 200 of them, not all in the Philippines. They started in January, Feb, obviously lasting till November, the summit in November. How much of this is just talk, and how much progress do you actually see? You've both been involved in this for at least a couple of years.
You're right. You know, we worked at it for a year. ABAC itself has met three times already, a fourth time coming up in November. And so we ask ourselves the same question, you know, are we limited to talk, or are we going to convert some of this talk into action? And I think if we take a look at the Philippine agenda and the APEC agenda, they've become more closely aligned, and so results are beginning to come out. Services, for instance, was not an area that APEC concentrated on too much. At the meeting over the last 2 days, together with the structural reform ministerial meeting, now they recognize services as a vital part of an economy and a vital part of inclusive growth. So they're looking for ways now to promote services aside from manufacturing and industry and trade. No, they now look at services as a tradable product. That's a big difference, because we used to always look at goods. So I think that's a big change. Another one I would say is, the field of urbanization. This is a sort of a new topic introduced only in the last maybe 1 or 2 years. It was very low profile, just on the edge of the radar screen. Now it's moved towards the center of the radar screen. A lot more attention being paid to issues of urbanization, connectivity, infrastructure, water quality, environment. Those things are beginning to come together. So
fact,
a lot more private sector participation.
Urbanization is one of the topics that will be taken up in the APEC CEO Summit. I'd like to talk about some of the sessions that will happen there. Two of them in particular, Mr. Tan Caktiong. One is about strategizing in this world where there's a lot of geopolitical and economic flashpoints. You are one of the Filipino businessmen who has the most investments, or the most investments in foreign countries.
Maybe one of them. Maybe
one
not
of
the
them.
Most.
we can check that out, but I think you're right up there. What do businessmen like you look out for, worry about, and also what kinds of opportunities do you see when you look around the world right now? you're very much invested in China. That's obviously one flashpoint right now.
I think from our point of view, to me personally, it's more always a mindset issue that if there's a challenge, then there's more opportunities. So it's always a balancing of mindset that especially in our category or our industry, we are quite resilient to the economic situation. So for example, like way back in the Philippines when we have some problems way back 1980s, we were expanding very aggressively. So I think one is we are lucky that we are in this industry that is quite resilient.
For other businessmen, what do you think they're looking out for?
Probably, I think, again, first would be have the right mindset. And I think look for, because basically you're serving some needs. So always have to be aware of the needs. And then probably try to balance long-term and maybe short-term and long-term.
So if
you're really going in for a long term, all these problems usually are just short term problems.
In fact, you're saying there are opportunities.
There will be opportunities.
So when China is going through what it's going through right now, for you, that's an opportunity to expand, to acquire?
Yes, that's right.
Do you find...
And sometimes, especially in our situation where we are considered like a retail trade, sometimes rental becomes more affordable.
Cheaper.
Yeah.
So you lock them in for a long term.
You can
lease.
Now, yeah.
Do you find that most of the businessmen you talk to have that similar mindset, or are many of them getting wary, especially in the last few months?
I think some will have their own characters, but if you talk to businessmen or entrepreneurs, a lot of them are quite more on the positive mindset, that they'll say, hey, this is the right time to start looking at things. Because when everything is doing well, everything's very expensive, right?
One of the other sessions is about entrepreneurship, mm-hmm. or about small and medium and micro enterprises. That's a big theme within APEC. How do APEC states encourage more entrepreneurship?
I think probably one is, of course, with the presence of APEC meeting here, I think that's already one sign of promoting awareness of this entrepreneurship. Another probably is for big businesses to help the SMMEs. For example, like in our case, we have the Farmers Entrepreneurship Program, where it's quite a difficult program to start with, but when it's being done well, we start helping a lot of farmers. And just to cut it short, for example, their income went up like 3 to 4 times at least. So I think that's one way of helping farmers becomes an entrepreneur, and then up to a point where a lot of other farmers in other regions, they heard about the success of the program and they want to start participating. So we have to look at what region can plant what produce, and then up to a point, if we cannot absorb all the products, we start helping by calling other institutions, other supermarkets, why don't you take a look at this?
So you become the middleman, but without the patong.
Yeah, that's right. And we make sure that even when we go direct to farmers, we make sure they get the right value.
What's in it for a big business like yours to establish, the term they use is establish those linkages with the small producers?
I think one is really the internal desire to really help. Because to do that, you face a lot of problems. I remember when we were doing this very early on, even our own purchasing will not buy. Because they said, there's a lot of issues. You have to work with them, delivery, train them.
Consistency in size.
Yeah, everything, yeah. But once it works out now, they were so surprised that the quality is much better.
Do states, APEC is about more than 20 governments. Do states have a role in encouraging entrepreneurship, or is it really all on private business like yourself?
I think both the government can also, like our Department of Trade has been very supportive of any SMMEs program. So I think they can also help, and probably like the area on customs and how to streamline operations. And I think that can help the businesses.
I think if you take a look at what the Philippines DTI, together with all the other trade ministers, They made micro, small, and medium scale enterprise central part of their ministerial plan and ministerial statement. They wanted to put more support because the recognition is that 90% of businesses are small and medium scale enterprise. If they are able to supply the larger companies like Jollibee and the other companies around the world, they will, of course, as already mentioned, they will multiply their income three or four times. They will deliver better quality products. They will improve their standards. They will learn from the new technology. They will supply others outside of their original client. So this year, the Philippines not only is hosting the trade ministerial meeting, but the SME ministerial meeting in a few weeks. And then they will sharpen their focus on how to help small and medium scale enterprise. And it's central to the Philippine strategy because, like all other APEC countries, we need to help a lot of the small and medium scale and the micro. Now it's beginning to cross over into what the finance ministerial meeting is also discussing, which is, you know, financial inclusion and access to capital, micro insurance for micro and small and medium scale businesses. So before, you know, you might think it's committees working as silos, not connecting to each other, but today we're beginning to see a lot of connection from one group of meetings or committees to another, and private sector people are actually able to move back and forth and help and advise and implement some of the ideas.
Okay.